Hey everybody, this is Rebecca Totila with Aroma Hut Institute. Welcome back to our channel. I'm so glad you're taking time to watch this video. Today I want to talk about essential oils and... You want to talk about essential oils too? Alright, here he comes, our aroma cat. Today, I want to talk about essential oils and whether or not they are flammable. In fact, this is probably the most frequently asked question that I get on our website. Let's go ahead and take a look now together, and let's look at this to find out if this is in fact true, whether or not essential oils are flammable.
So let's take a look now at this article on our website. This one is entitled, Are Essential Oils Flammable? One of the reasons we want to take this into consideration is because we are using oils in so many various ways. And a lot of times people will just maybe want to put a drop or two in their candle. But they're finding now with this recent trend that oils are so popular that there's been a lot of reports gathered concerning the dangers of unsupervised or careless use of essential oils. This is something we want to take into consideration, that essential oils are volatile. A substance is classified as volatile. This means that it is flammable, it is dangerous, and can become very unstable. So flammable substances are determined by their flashpoint value. And this is the lowest temperature at which a substance can ignite when there is a ignition source, which is something that would be in close proximity. Most volatile substances that are flammable have a flash point of more than 60 degrees Celsius or 140 degrees Fahrenheit. So if you've ever wondered if essential oils are flammable, the answer is yes. However, they all have different flash points and are classified according to that varying degree of flammability. So tea tree, lavender, and citrus oils all have a flash point of 50 to 60 degrees Celsius, which would be anywhere between 122 to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. So what is flash point? Well, all essential and fragrant oils and aroma chemicals are volatile and will evaporate. This is what you'll probably notice, some of your oils disappearing in the bottle, some more than others, and this is due to a low flash point. So most are flammable, but the temperature at which they ignite differs from oil to oil. One of the things you might want to think about too is if you're leaving your essential oils in the car, or if they're being stored in a garage or in a basement or attic, wherever there would be just not a very good place to place them, you want to pay attention to that. Now, all flammable liquids have a vapor pressure. Therefore, as the temperature of the oil increases, the vapor pressure increases. And this increasing of volume of the evaporated liquid is in the air, and that's the flash point. Flash point is the minimum temperature in which there is sufficient evaporated oil in the air that can ignite. And you saw that in the little clip of the spray of the oil coming out of the orange that was in those little sacks and pockets on the outside of the rind. And that was the essential oil that was sparking that fire, making that flame to flare up and show a little bit of a spark. On the website, you're going to find a couple of charts here. You'll want to get this information from your essential supplier and use this as a reference. Check with your supplier, and if they have a safety data sheet attached to the information that they provide on their website for the essential oils, they will probably list the flash point, and it's going to vary slightly from batch to batch. But keep in mind that the essential with the lowest flush point, you know, when you're blending your oils, this is the one that you're going to be going by, the one with the lowest flash point. So here's just a little cutout I did of a sheet that I had from New Directions Aromatics, actually, and it shows that the flash point is 49 degrees Celsius, and I have a little arrow here so you can find that. So I have it broken down by essential oil with the centigrade and the Fahrenheit. So you can see right at the top here, aniseed is 90 degrees centigrade and then 194 Fahrenheit. And let's just go down here and look for some of the others that might be a little lower. Grapefruit, look at that one. Grapefruit is 43 degrees Celsius, 109 Fahrenheit. Wow, that's pretty low actually. Think about it, if you were out in the desert, lived out in Las Vegas or some of the other states that are get really hot in the summertime, this would be a problem. Your oils are going to get vaporized basically if they don't ignite. So this is something you want to take into consideration. I know that I've had a problem with oils evaporating and also seeming to just vaporize because of the temperature that they're stored at. Okay, so you can take a look at this and you'll see a lot of the different temperatures. Most of them are high, but you will find like nutmeg is 100 degrees, mandarin's 107, lemon is 118 degrees. So there's a lot of big differences here. Now the chemicals are also broken down. This is good information for those of you who make soaps or make any other kind of crafts in which you want to know this information, so that when you are preparing your products, you want to know this. So should anyone worry about essential oils catching fire when they're diffusing them? I don't think that we probably will have a problem with this. It usually isn't going to be the case. Let's say you did drop a few drops of lavender into your candle. For the most part, I don't think this is going to be a problem. But it's probably not a good practice either. You're going to want to use the proper equipment when you're diffusing your essentials. Now, for those who might be using their essential oils in their dryer, essential oils used on those wool balls that you might throw in your dryer, you got to keep in mind that most dryers, and this is just a general case, modern dryers have at least three general cycles. Okay, you have the low heat for delicates, the medium heat for permanent press, and then you have the high heat for regular clothes. The temperature range is going to be between 125 to 135 across all these cycles. If you're going to be using essentials, then you need to make sure that you do not use an oil that is going to have a lower flash point, because that could pose a fire risk when you're adding these to dryer sheets or to dryer balls. I personally have used lavender. I've never had a problem, but then again, I'm not really sure if I want to risk a house fire, so I've sort of ceased from doing that. I decided to just add the essential oils after I finish my cycle. Just drop some oil on a towel and maybe run it through this cycle. But it's not really something I'm not concerned about it. Should you be concerned, you might want to think about that. Okay, so tips on how to avoid essential fires. Although not all vaporized essentials can ignite or will catch fire, it's not advisable to use oils close to an open fire or in, let's say if you're using them in the kitchen, you don't want to store them next to an open gas flame for a stove. You never want to store your essential oils close to an open fire or a fireplace. And you'll want to avoid using your oils on a naked flame candle to perfume a room. You really want to use the proper equipment and a diffuser when you're using the oils, because you don't want the heat to destroy the chemical compositions and the therapeutic properties that you're looking to benefit from. So we do suggest that you use a mist diffuser when you want to be safe. These are convenient, they're simple, easy to use. It's the best way to deliver the oils into the air.
Okay, well, I hope that helped you in your studies on essential oils. And if you found that valuable, please give us a like. And if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel. We would love to have you come back and join us again for our next video. Thanks for watching.